You'd been a diplomat?
Yes.
You had been a correspondent for Radio Free Europe? When you became president, how did you know that the future was the digitizing of Estonia?
Well, I knew that actually when I was an ambassador. And the story to that was that I looked at this, what I mentioned, this huge gap in income. And I said, how are we ever going to catch up? Because all these other countries, I mean, not only Finland, but all the countries in Western Europe had had 50 years of growth and building new infrastructure, and everything was very good and kind of very Western, and we were still stuck there. And then you also face in development Zeno's paradox, and where Achilles is always trying to catch up with the tortoise, mm-hmm. but the tortoise always remains mm-hmm. ahead. Same thing with development. I mean, if you're going to, you may get more advanced, but the old countries, the old rich countries, are also growing. And so a couple of things happened. One of the things was that I had become convinced that we needed to digitize because it was the one area where we could be on a level playing field. Because it was just starting out. And really that first inspirational moment was the first web browser, which was called Mosaic, which right. came out 3 years after the whole HTTP thing. I mean, the Hypertext Transfer Protocol, which was the basis of the internet, was invented, but it wasn't usable. And the first web browser came out, and I went, having been a geek my whole life, and I'll get to that, I went and bought it for $29.95 at Radio Shack and uploaded 7 floppy disks. And then I said, here's the web. And I looked at this and said, well, this is one thing that we can do that we are starting out. We're not behind the US or Germany or Japan or any other country. And so, okay, how do we do this? And then the second thing that, which actually made me a geek, was I was fortunate enough when I was in 10th grade to have a math teacher who was doing her PhD in math education at Teachers College, Columbia. And her idea was, let's see if we could teach kids to program or code. And so she got a teletype and a big fat modem, which was connected to a mainframe 30 miles away. I mean, that was the level of yeah.
So you and Bill Gates and a few others learned to code when you were teenagers.
Yes. And so I learned to code, 62 years ago. Mm-hmm. And so I was never fearful of this, but so I took the first idea. I said, okay, we should really digitize. And the second part of this was, well, if we're going to digitize, the best way to do it is start young. And I then proposed to the government that we put computer labs in every school in the country and we connect them all up via the internet. And as I said, it was a very young government, and they said, well, that's a pretty wild idea. Why don't we do it?
Yes.
And so they did. And so very quickly, the younger people in the country were very digitally savvy. And later on, we did all kinds of things for older people as well. But that's how it got started. And then this continued basically for about 8 years, 7 years, when you realize that if we really want to do this right, we have to have a very serious, robust digital system, something that you can't hack and so forth. And we put that in place in basically 2000. Mm-hmm. And using technology using methods that to this day are not used, for example, in the United States, except for the US military. I mean, that's a big problem. I think one of the reasons why the United States is really falling apart is digitally, is not going where it should be going.